Hello, this is Victor at RestoreYourMercedes.com. Today at the workshop we have a wiring harness that came from customer in Nevada. And this is V12 600 SL lower engine harness. Now there are many names for it. There is one of them called, you know, some people go by calling it positive cable harness. Some references call it starter alternator harness. Some just call starter harness, some just call alternator harness. So some call lower engine harness. So many names, but it is just one harness that goes under the car, connects on the through the vehicle. It connects through the floor of the car. On the passenger side, there is a plastic cover that goes slants upwards, and you can remove it. You're gonna see this connector and this positive cable going there. That's basically a junction point, separates interior of the car from the exterior. It's like a grommet. And this is on the outside of the car, and it's bolted to the side of the engine through these these brackets here. All right, so basically just wanted to show you what happens, because everybody neglect this harness and then there are serious issues and problems that arise from this harness shorting out. So what do we have here? So we have two connectors. This is main positive. This goes directly to the battery, not fused, and it goes through the to the starter. Okay. And in here it goes straight to the alternator. So here we have two thick positive cables. Now, thinner cables. This one right here activates your starter. This one, if I remember correctly, is a oil level sensor to show how much oil you have in your pan. Here we have oil pressure sensor. And this one is to activate alternator to basically generate power to recharge battery. Now, it all seemed to be like not super important, but it is very important. Now, the shorting cable here can short anywhere in the harness for the whole length. I mean, during this length, during the run, can short with any of these wires anywhere. Same for this one. This cable basically always receives positive signal to energize the alternator, and then it shorts with this one, and obviously it goes straight to your cluster, and then it can basically burn out your cluster. Same success can happen with the same success. These wires can short also, so when there's a signal going to activate the starter, then they would short with the oil level sensor, and then short out that circuit. Not good at all. Now, the worst can happen is that if these wires get shorted out to the positive somewhere and they start heating up wires that go inside the car. I bought the car once that had wires shorted so bad that wires just fused with each other, and then one would heat up so much that it would melt through the harness. The harness is this thick. To get to that harness, you have to remove whole dashboard and HVAC box, because it lays right behind all that, so you cannot just pull it out. You have to remove lots of things. So obviously you don't want to do that, so might as well take care of this harness before it gives problems. V12s, V8s, 93 to 95, in some 96s, they're prone to this failure. All of this biodegradable wiring is installed in these harnesses. Now, this harness is no longer available, so this can only be repaired. It cannot be replaced anymore. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to repair this particular harness as it sits, but it's going to be very nice when I finish with it. It's going to be very factory looking. All the wires are going to go through the same grommets. I'm not cutting anything. These will remain where they are, just to make it look really nice and clean. This basically, that's it. I mean, just wanted to show you the problem with these harnesses, what happens, and you be the judge. If you need to repair it, I can certainly repair it. That's fine, but it is advisable to do it. On all my cars, they were all in this shape. I had so many Benzes, and all of these 90s Benzes, they have these issues with biodegradable cables, not only in harnesses, but in throttle bodies for that matter. You got throttle bodies that I just repaired for somebody. So, but this is important. Just look under the car, look near your alternator, and look at the alternator starting cable. This is pretty much bare. If it's just losing insulation, as in this case, as you can see, there is no insulation left on it. Well, yeah, I can be wrong. This is like a 3/4 inch insulation left on it. But that's about all that's left on it. So if you bend it, there goes your 3/4 inch of alt insulation. So it is totally unacceptable. So I replaced these wires with military grade cables that do not fail ever. So that's the way to go. You can look at this wire, you can look at the wire next to it, which is the pressure, oil pressure sensor. Take a look at that one if you see any signs of deterioration. It could be actually oil level sensor, and that could be oil pressure sensor. I just don't remember the orientation. Mercedes changed designs in 90, I believe in 96, it was a little different design. But anyway, one and the other, I mean, these are both for oil sensors. One is pressure, one is level. So anyway, just look at these wires and see if they've fallen apart. And if they do, then if they are falling apart, then, you know, I can repair it. So again, this was Victor at restoremercedes.com, and I'll make another video when this harness is finished to show customer that it's ready to go and ready to be mailed out. This is an emergency job. I will do it overnight and then mail it back tomorrow with overnight shipping, because customer's car is at the shop, and obviously it is not running at the moment. You cannot start it without this harness, of course. Okay, well, again, Victor here at restoremercedes.com. Thanks for watching.